These glaciers turn out to be really close to where people live, and they live in really rapidly expanding urban areas, but they also live in areas like Peru, where we have the largest production of export asparagus production, for example. A lot of agriculture that's being grown on the desert coast that otherwise is not productive, but thankfully we have all this extra water that buffers the rivers and provides for this abundant resource.
Basically, as these glaciers recede, as a result of rising temperatures, we expect to see a reduction in dry season water supply and an increase in the variability of dry season water supply. So the work that we're using the UAVs for is, one, doing really high scale, high resolution mapping of volume or mass balance changes in the glaciers, and then also looking at how the water flows down through those systems. So we can start looking at things like soil moisture storage, pathways of water through these wetland systems. The goal being that we can, if we get a bit more complete understanding of the hydrologic system within the area, we can start to think about how that's going to change in the future, how future water provision may change, how that may impact people's lives. What we're trying to do is map two things. So one, we're trying to create orthophotos or orthomosaics, which is basically a stitch, kind of like a panorama of the landscape to create these really high resolution images. And then we also create these digital elevation models, which is basically a representation of the Earth surface, where each pixel, like in a photo, has, instead of a color value, it has an elevation value. So we can do these at really high resolution. The process for collecting this data is basically we go up, we do a series of GPS survey first, so with survey grade GPS, where we're surveying to millimeter or centimeter accuracy. Go down, set up the UAV, send that up, and that will fly over this area that we've got some ground control points in. As it moves over the area, it collects hundreds to thousands of photos of this region, and it captures those, and then we match similar points across all these photos to create an elevation model.
Here at Ohio State University, we're trying to understand climate change from the perspective of what causes it, but really when, what are the consequences? But what's happening is these glaciers are responding to a global force signal that we're all helping to produce. And then the response to that is a water resource issue that touches into issues of food security, that touches into a globalized economy that relies on export agriculture. So there's feedbacks and interactions between all of these elements. So that's one of the reasons we're focused on these tropical glaciers.